Hey, welcome to Apple A Day. In today's episode, I'm going to show you how to take single camera footage and edit it like a three camera shoot using the MultiCam feature built into Final Cut Pro. So if you're a Final Cut Pro user, keep watching for multi-camera editing from a single camera shoot on Apple A Day. All right. So as you can see, I've already got a Final Cut Pro project open and ready to go. I've already imported the sample footage that I want to use to show off the multi-camera functionality. Now, one thing that I should make clear is that this technique will only work if you shoot the original footage in 4K, because we're jumping in to the clip. In other words, we're scaling it up like 160%. So for that to work and look good, your original footage has to be very high resolution, 4K, and you are exporting this as 1080 or HD. Technically, you can scale up to 200%, not lose any resolution when you export the final video. This footage here, as you can see on the top right, the resolution is indeed 4K. And I want to do a quick shout out to our friends at BrewTalk that we actually shoot their podcast in our studio. So the first thing we need to do is I need to create a new project. I'm going to select new project and I'm just going to call it MultiCam example. And we want to make sure that this project is in 1080. And as you can see, it's not. I just have to hit modify. And I'm just going to change that from 4K to 1080. What we want to do now is basically take the BrewTalk clip, and I'm going to create a compound clip out of it by holding down Option G, and brings up the window to create a compound clip. And I'm going to call this wide shot. And then I'm going to make another clip, and I'm going to call it camera left. And I'm going to make a third clip, and I'm going to call it camera right. Now, these are all exactly the same. We haven't changed anything. So the wide shot, we're not going to do anything with. It's going to remain exactly as is. Now, camera left, we need to scale that image up and zoom in onto the gentleman on the left. So if I double click on camera left, it will open it up in the timeline. And then I can select it and I can go over to my transform properties and change the scale to 160%. And then I'm going to adjust the vertical position where it looks like it's about right. And then the horizontal to get him over. I don't want him centered, but just like kind of like to the left, just like that, maybe a little bit lower. I'm going to copy this. So I have a starting point. And I'm going to double click on camera right, and I'm going to do the same thing, but just to make it a little bit easier, I'm going to paste in the transformation that I already made by holding Command, Shift, and V. And that brings up this window to paste attributes. And I'm just going to paste in the position and the scale. Of course, it's blowing it up and adjusted the position to match what's on camera left, but I want it to be camera right. So I'm going to take the X position, and I'm going to slide that over right about there. And I'm actually going to adjust the Y position too, because he's not as high up on screen as the other gentleman. There we go. So now we've got our wide shot, we've got our camera right, and we've got our camera left. In order to make these into a multi-camera clip, we need to assign each video an angle. So I'm going to select wide shot. I'm going to go over to info, and where it says camera angle, I'm going to type in A. And then for camera left, I'm going to type in B. And for camera right, I'm going to type in C. So now each clip has its own angle. So if I select all three, and then I right-click on them, in the menu that appears, I'm going to select Multicam Clip. And I'm going to I just give it a name, multicam example. And I'm going to go to the project that we created. And I'm going to drag the multicam example into the project, just like that. And at first glance, it doesn't look any different. But what I want to do is select view under the viewer and choose to show angles. And there you go. You got three angles now, simulating a multi-camera shoot. So if I hit the space bar to play, while it's playing, I can change camera angles. I can do that by typing in 1, 2, or 3, or I can actually go up to the camera angle viewer and select the angle that I want to see. Notice that the cursor changes to a cut tool, which is exactly what I want to happen when I click on one of these other camera angles. It actually makes a cut and then changes it to that angle. So if I click on it right here and I play it back, you can see it cuts to angle number 3. And I can click on the angles as many times as I want. If I press play, I can do this like a live recording and just change angles constantly. So I'm going to do that right now. So I want to jump to angle 2. And then going to do a wide shot. Go to angle 3 to show his response. Go back to angle 2. Back to 3. Show a wide shot. And you can see, while that happened, it made cuts in my timeline. I'm just going to close the angles so you can see the window a little bit clearer. So if I hit play now, you can watch the cuts happen. And that's it. That's all there is to it. It's so much easier than the way I used to do it. I used to do this the hard way. I used to make the cuts manually with the blade tool, grab the section that I wanted to change, adjust the scaling and the position. Then I would save that off as an effect preset using this button right here. So you would save it and give it a name, say camera left, and then I would do the same thing for the right-hand side, camera right. It made it a little easier. You know, you would make the cuts, select the clip, double-click on the saved effect, and repeat. Obviously, doing it as a multicam shoot makes it a hell of a lot easier. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed that. I hope it was valuable. It certainly saved a lot of time for me. And again, I want to thank Eric Robert at BrewTalk for letting me use his footage shot in our studio. And if you're interested in brewing beer, you can check out his podcast. I put in the link below. Thanks for watching this tutorial on multi-camera editing in Final Cut Pro. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm John Martins, and I will see you next time on Apple a Day.